I met with Libby Darling from South Coast Sirens, a group dedicated to making the sea around the south coast of the UK permanently free from pollution and sewage spills.
We've just been for a swim and it was absolutely gorgeous. But what we really don't want to find is when we're swimming that there's going to be sewage in the sea, because we're well aware that there are sewage outs at Saltdean as well as at Shoreham, in fact all the way along the south coast. And it's absolutely, completely unacceptable that sewage is released into the sea and to any waterways, rivers as well. And that leads directly into all of the ocean. It spreads everywhere. So, you know, it is not acceptable. The question we want to ask you today is, do you want to swim in raw sewage? I think you're probably going to say no. Do we want our children swimming in raw sewage? Again, I think you're going to say no. And lastly, really, do we want sewage to be affecting nature? You know, because there are fish out there, there are seabirds out there, there are dolphins, mammals, whales, seals, you know, all sorts of creatures relying on the sea, as well as ourselves. And again, I think the answer here is no. And it just makes us all, me in particular, incredibly cross to know that Southern Water and other water companies think that it's acceptable to release any sewage at any time. If it's raining, that's not okay to let poo and other bits into the sea. Anyway, as an aside of that, the sewage affects us humans. We end up with eye infections, ear infections, stomach problems. You know, it's well documented that you can get poorly from swimming in the sea after there's been a sewage out, which is absolutely not okay. One thing we really, really need to work hard on is lobbying the government and our MPs and making sure that there is legislation in place that stops any sewage being let out into any waterway. That's the oceans, the seas, the same thing, and rivers.
Last month down at Southern Water, they entered a guilty plea, illegally dumping sewage out into our lovely sea. Another nail in the coffin, that privatisation works. They screw us and then pollute us. They're taking the waterworks under the sea, dump full of wee. It used to be better down where it's wetter, but they're taking the pee.
We want to tell you about our call to action, which is all about crowdfunding so that we can raise money so that we can start testing the water locally, so that we can really, really get a true picture of what's happening locally. We know the Environment Agency are testing, but we really want to give them a hand doing that as well. So hopefully you can support our crowdfunding. It'll be on the bottom of the link. So please help us, that'd be brilliant. And lastly, I'm an avid beach cleaner. Things that we find in the seas and the rivers. Now, this is a wet wipe. Apparently are flushable. They are not flushable. They're made of plastic. Please don't flush wet wipes. In fact, don't use a wet wipe. Use a flannel and wash it. It's easy. We almost need to go back to the 1940s, where we didn't have all of these things like wet wipes and facial wipes and just any old wipe. We just don't need them. And again, I think, you know, the water companies need to go back to the 1940s when they used gravel as a substrate. Because another thing that we're finding on our beaches here are these things. They're called biobeads. This one here, can you see that? And then these ones here. Now, there's a difference between a biobead, which these two are, and a nurdle. Now, a nurdle is a raw, that's a nurdle. That's raw stuff to make plastics. But these biobeads here and here, the bag is full of them, are used in the sewage industry to treat sewage as a substrate. So it sits in the raw sewage and helps to take all the poisons, the toxins. I'm not a scientist, so I can't tell you exactly what it's taking out, but it takes all the nasties out of the sewage as part of the treatment. Now, we're finding these on our beaches and on our rivers, so we again know that these are ending up in our environment. And not only that, but they're covered in toxins.
and they're going to affect anyone that's swimming. I mean, those little things floating around on the sea, if you're swimming like that, like me, like a fish, you could end up swallowing them, and the fish are going to end up swallowing them, and the dolphins. It's not good. So please, Southern Water, stop putting sewage into our sea.